On this episode of UTR, we get creative and celebrate the incredible endeavor of art. We'll sample some thoughtful audible art, magnificent murals, and an awesome illustrator. Then we'll swing by a cool, colorful collection and blow some glass that'll blow your mind. Get ready to explore the artful people, places, and things that make Michigan a great place to be creative.
Let's catch up. Not online or over text. Let's catch up in a place where time isn't measured in minutes, but in moments. Moments made paddling the day away on a crystal blue waterway. Or just sitting around a campfire beneath a canopy of twinkling stars. It's time to make up for lost time. This summer, let's catch up with Pure Michigan.
The Michigan Economic Development Corporation is dedicated to enabling economic prosperity. The MEDC markets Michigan with a focus on growing businesses and building resilient communities in our state.
A visit to the Stalls Auto Collection will take you back to a time when cars were more than just a way to get around. A fantastic assortment of gas pumps, neon signs, and automated music machines dating back 150 years that must be seen and heard. Info at stallsauto.com. AnnArbor.org is your gateway to Chelsea, Dexter, Manchester, Milan, Saline, Ypsilanti, and Ann Arbor. Find out the best spots to eat, festivals to attend, activities to do, and places to discover at AnnArbor.org.
I've been around the world, but there's one place I keep coming back to. And the more I explore, the more I realize it's the place to be. I'm Tom Dalton, and this is Under the Radar, Michigan.
Now, if you've watched this show before, you know that I always say that art is the icing on the cake of life. Well, if you live in Michigan, I hope you like a lot of icing. Well, look, art.
That's because we have so many creative and awesome artful artisans in our great state that you can't throw almost anything without hitting one. Don't hurt them. From whimsical sidewalk stylings and fine classic creations to Shakespeare in the Sun, and even enormous iron art, we've got your cognitive creative cravings covered.
So put on your smock, your beret, and get ready to light up your frontal lobes, because we're about to get artsy on you. Hey guys, you want some? I bought six. Whoa!
Our first artistic offering is one you actually have to hear to believe. It's audible art made by a man who not only makes music, he even manufactures some of the creative contraptions that carry his melodies. Frank Paul is an award-winning teacher, composer, performer, and writer from Wyandotte who makes creative music for your mind, body, and soul. He's actually what you might call a sonic artist who goes beyond the conventional to bring you the conceptual.
What is your inspiration for what you do? How did you come into this kind of music?
I think with most art forms, somebody has to kind of give you permission. And so most people that like chance music, John Cage gives them permission. I was listening to rock bands in the probably late 70s, early 80s.
Me too.
And I heard Eugene Chadbourne, and he sometimes plays a plunger, and he plays an electric plunger, and he plays an electric rake. And they weren't great sounds, but he was the person, after seeing him and meeting him and getting to know him, that ultimately gave me permission.
Gotcha.
You know, that anything is music.
But you're brilliant at taking stuff that, I don't know where you scavenged and find these things, but taking stuff and turning them
into... The sad thing is, you could point and I could probably tell you. That's what takes up my brain.
Yeah, but you take, it's like, it's part music, part mechanics, and it's, you've turned these music into these creative little audioscapes that take your brain to so many different places. I mean, how do you even do that?
You need a day job.
Oh, yeah.
You definitely need a day job.
I'm still looking for one.
Yeah. And I copy edited for over 15 years. Bought the house I have a rental property. That gave me enough time so that I thought if I spend my time going to yard sales and flea markets, it won't be totally wasted. I have something to fall back on.
Yeah, who do you make the music for?
Oddly enough, during the pandemic, Bandcamp.
And you also score short films?
Yes, and dance kept me employed for a long time, and theater.
Okay. Now, what would you call the genre that you, this performance art music that you do?
Every piece is different, so it would depend upon the piece.
For you personally, is it the performance or is it the preparation that you love? Do you love being in the studio and creating, and or is it all about the performance when you're on stage?
Well, I spend most of my music making is recording, and then it leaves my brain. You know, I the piece that I was playing earlier, I tuned this zither.
Oh, that's just a zither?
Well, it's an auto zither now.
Yeah.
But I tune that for a specific tune. Once it goes out of tune, that tune it disappears, except for the recording that I have.
Who wants to do that again?
It is very awkward. You know, I still get hired regularly to do music for theater, film, and dance. And it's very awkward when I'm doing live theater and somebody says, Frank, can you play? And they'll mention one of my tunes. And it's like, I don't know what that tune is. And even if I did know the tune, I wouldn't know that that was the name of it.
Ladies and gentlemen, Frank Paul. He'll be here all week. Try the beef.
Well, you heard right. Frank Paul is an absolute innovator, pioneer, and one heck of a creative composer. And a pretty nice guy, I might add. So if you're feeling audibly adventurous and you'd like to delve outside of your mundane music box, look him up. That's Frank Paul, P-A-H-L. Trust me, your cerebral cortex will thank you for it.
Well, next up, we're gonna go big. No, I mean really big. In order to see this art, you gotta take a step back. One more. Keep going. There, now you got it.
Mural art is something you're seeing more and more of, and for good reason. They create a welcoming and colorful sense of life in a downtown. And in Ann Arbor, murals do an artful job of reminding you why this city is one of the best places on earth to live, work, and play. And one of the reasons why Ann Arbor is exploding with color and creativity these days is Mary Thiefels, a thoroughly thought-provoking person who's accelerating this awe-inspiring art form.
When did you first realize that you were creative, and when did your art get so big?
Well, I think we all start out creative. I think something happens when we reach adolescence where we start doubting our own creativity,
and instead of
stopping, I just plowed through those developmental phases with gusto. Studying art was something that was always on the forefront of my mind. I love how throughout history, through the beginning, since the dawn of man, we have been using our hands and our voices and our expression to create things, yeah. Right? To communicate things.
But this mural is amazing. What was the inspiration for this one?
Well, it started with a partnership, and that's how all of our projects become born, really, is with people that have ideas. Destination Ann Arbor approached Daniel and I, and we started scouting for a location. They knew they wanted to work with Tree Town Murals, but we didn't have our wall yet. So we went through a process of just investigating where this piece, the centerpiece, could go, because we definitely wanted the mural to celebrate our community. So this was the biggest piece of eye candy we could find. And when we lobbied to the building owners, Wickfield Properties, they were extremely amenable to the idea.
Now, this particular mural is called Challenge Everything, Create Anything.
It's a pretty bold statement, right?
It is a bold statement, but it's, I have to ask, I mean, to do something like this, you have to be part mathematician, part engineer, part daredevil.
Right, right.
I mean, to go up that high and paint something that, and still keep it in proportion, how do you do that?
I think that one of the things that drives Daniel and I the most is the challenge. And so this being the biggest wall we've painted, we had to talk to the right people. We had to figure out what our plan was.
It's such a, like I said, it's math, it's engineering, it's daredevil, it's, don't you get scared when you're all the way up there trying to, no?
No, it's actually exhilarating.
Wow.
It's pretty, the view of Ann Arbor was just breathtaking.
Well, speaking of Ann Arbor, love Ann Arbor. Well, I love the creative spirit and energy here. Why do you think murals like this are so important to cities?
Sure. I mean, if you notice, murals are popping up all over the world. And so it's not just important to cities, but it's important to humanity. It's brought art outside. And murals have been, you know, part of our human dialogue and conversation since we could make a pigment and put our hand on the wall. You know, we want to make our mark and say we were here. But then there's artists that also want to represent larger bodies of people or larger communities by using big pictures. So these are big pictures on wall that can evoke conversation, awe, excitement, curiosity. You know, like, we need to jump out of our skin sometimes to feel that we're alive and we're in the moment. And I think art does that.
Let's face it, when was the last time a big blank brick wall made you think, smile, or wonder? Well, thanks to awesome artists like Mary and Daniel, Ann Arbor's walls are filling up with fantastic and inspirational art. Some of them way up. So if you find yourself just staring at a big wall, don't worry. There's probably a mural on it. Bonus.
Now, I just spent some time with a creative creature from planet Earth who's as much fun to talk to and as art is to look at. I think that's me. Now, you watch this. I'm going to go set up our next adventure.
I'm talking about Dave Chow, an award-winning teacher, artist, and illustrator who's turned his nonstop noodling into a very successful career. When he's not storyboarding or creating images for corporate America, he's sharing his inspirations on Instagram or even lending his creative eye to TV commercials. Let's say we get to know Dave through the art of conversation.
You know, Dave, this is going to sound strange coming from me because we know each other.
Uh-huh.
But I have a great deal of respect I have a great deal of respect for what you do because I tried doing it myself in college. I took two-dimensional drawing, three-dimensional drawing. They even tried the fourth dimension with me, and I just can't do it. I mean, kudos to, I don't know where it came from.
Stunt doubles. I have stunt doubles in the back. There's actually a Vietnamese Family 7 over there that does all my work right now for a pound of rice a week.
Well, I want to ask you, what was little Dave like when you were you drawing on everything?
Everything. One of these days we should sit down. You know, I've got a friend of mine that's actually written a book on this. The history of Chinese restaurants in North America.
What? I thought we were talking about drawing.
Okay, but here's the thing. When my dad came here in 54.
Yeah.
Got to Canada, met his dad for the very first time. I think my dad was like 24, 25. Met his dad for the very first time. My grandfather owned a coffee shop. So my dad was his donut maker. Okay, so he's like 27 years old. I'm working for dad in Canada as a donut maker. Dad says, son, you're going home to China. Get yourself a bride. Marries my mom in China. Back in 65, they pop me out. So next thing you know, hey, let's take Dave to the coffee shop. I start drawing on everything.
Oh, in the coffee, so that's how it started. Coffee?
No, he's decaf for the sun, lady. I started going nuts on the placemats. So we can't afford that. Here's the Coca-Cola blackboard. You know, the daily specials. My dad got an extra one, got me one of those for home.
I've always tried to wrap my head around what you do, because you do so much, you do a little bit of everything.
I do a little of everything. I taught for 17 years.
You taught at CCS?
I taught at CCS, my alma mater. But before going to do that, you know, for myself, you know, for my own sense of balance or practicing what I preach, I worked 17 years in the industry before I went and taught. Because, you know, I'm not into this, I got a degree, I can go teach. No, you know, the thing that I brought to the classroom was I still do it for a living. I mean, there are multiple times I would show up for class and I'm like, pulled an all-nighter and, you know, I look worse than the kids do. You know, there's a running joke that the kids slept more than I did, usually in my class. I work, you know, I do this first and foremost, and then I went back and taught for 17 years.
Well, that's what I love about your stuff. There's humor to it. It's cartoony, but that's what I love about it.
Yeah. I mean, and honestly, it's like, I grew up on Mad Magazine, all these weird comic books, all these weird things. I mean, it's like, I think I still have an issue or two here stashed on my desk, but you know, it's like, I love that sense of humor because not only is it drawing, but it's also verbal. It's the written thing. It's the whole package. I just draw my way through life if I have to. It comes in handy.
You're my hero.
Or if you guys ever need help playing Pictionary, I'm your chemical engineer friend.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, everything I draw, what's that? What's that? What's that?
I used to, the in-laws used to make me draw left-handed.
Why? Just to improve your skills?
No, or? Just so they can slow me down at least a little bit, but.
Oh, can you draw left-handed?
I can draw left-handed. Oh. Now the skill I want is I want to be able to double, if I can just do this.
We're at two different projects in the same.
No, I can't do this. No.
If you've got an artful inner child who's just aching for some attention, check out the awesome illustrations of One Dave Chow. They'll make you think, laugh, dream, and wish you had his endless creative energy. They might even inspire you to pick up a pencil, and that Dave would love.
Now, if you want to see some great art, you go to a museum. But if you want to purchase some great art, you go to a gallery. But if you want to go to a really cool gallery, well, you know where I'm going with this.
It's called the Nanamdi Center for Contemporary Art, and it's one of the most interesting, awesome, artful adventures you can take. George Nanamdi started this nonprofit gallery and exhibition space years ago with a mission to enlighten all of us through art. And by Jove, I think he's done it. The gallery is located in the historic Sugar Hill District in Midtown Detroit. An area with a long history of tolerance, creativity, entertainment, and inspired people making their mark. And speaking of people making their mark, time for me to make mine.
Boy, I don't even know where to start with this place because it's a cultural, artistic, social experience here.
Yeah.
I mean, not only do you, because you don't just feature artists, you help promote the artists as well,
yeah,
correct?
Yeah, you're correct. Right, I think you have to do both. It just you feature the artist, yeah, it's good for that day or week or what have you. But when you really work to promote their careers, that's where I think you have really done the best for the artist, and that's what we have. We've always have done that.
So when did, this place been here for how long?
When we finished the renovation of this place, it was 12 years ago.
Right.
We moved here 20 years ago now, and we moved from Birmingham, Michigan.
Right.
All right, and we were out there 13 years.
Oh, okay.
And before that, we were 7 years in the city. So this is my 40th year
of promoting
and being in the art business like this, like what you see around this area. Mm-hmm. You know, you have MOCAD, Museum of Contemporary Art. You have the Detroit Artist Market. Although none of these things were here when I was coming. When I was coming from Birmingham, everyone thought it was the most foolish thing that I could have done. Because, move from Birmingham, one of the richest communities in the country,
right,
to Detroit. So, but I knew it was time, and that's what I wanted to do.
Well, tell me a little bit about the artists you have on display here right now, because you're primarily African-American artists.
It's primarily, yes.
Okay.
Yeah, but we do a lot with all artists, particularly in Detroit, we do that. But we are primarily African-American artists. But I always tell people, Detroit gives you more, like if you're a local artist, it's your home base, Detroit pays more attention to you. Then Chicago, it's like if you're not national or international, they give you very little attention.
Yeah, this place, again, for people who come here, like I said, it's an experience. You've got what's called the Black Box,
where you
have jazz performances.
Yeah, they have performances.
You've got a wine bar.
Yes.
You're connected to Savah,
yeah,
which
yeah.
is an incredible vegetarian restaurant.
Yes, it is. Yeah.
So you're in a good place.
Yeah. Well, I had hoped to do this like that, but it's just been a joy. I really have enjoyed being able to do what I do in Detroit. I really credit a lot to Detroit too. By the way, it was a city that had a lot of the things that that we as a family wanted to have in our life, I mean, it has challenges, but it's like,
yeah.
What's challenges,
Yeah.
If you've got an artful eye, trust me, you'll need both of them at the Nanamdi Center for Contemporary Art, because the depth and breadth of the creativity on display here will keep you coming back to experience more. And let's face it, you can never have too much art.
Have you ever wondered how you can take a bunch of sand, heat it up, and turn it into incredible art like this? Well, stick around, because things are about to get hot. Real hot.
Well, things aren't only going to get hot, they're going to get talented too. Because April Wagner is a gifted artist and artisan who takes one of nature's simplest substances and turns it into priceless, eye-pleasing pieces of art. Well, not priceless, because you can actually buy some of this stuff. April owns and operates Epiphany Studios in Pontiac. And when she's not making an incredibly creative, one-of-a-kind piece of art, she's talking about it with someone like, well, me.
Well, first of all, what you do is extremely cool, obviously. But I have a very important question, just one question. I know this is hard to do. So how long did it take until you made something that you could actually show your friends? Because, I mean, it's hand-eye coordination, it's a balancing act. You have to be so physically coordinated and talented, as well as artistic in your head, right?
It takes a couple of years to figure out how to get your hands to do what your mind wants it to do, and even then, you're still really struggling. There's so many technical components to blowing glass that when you're trying to add the artistic component on top of it, you've got to learn all of that technical information first and then start applying the concept.
What amazes me is the ovens that you use are massive to begin with. And what are the temperatures of these things?
So we are running an 800-pound tank of molten glass. It's clear, and that's running at 2,000 degrees. And that's running 24/7. So a lot of the expense people see in glass is that time it takes to learn the technical skill, and then the time and the energy that goes into keeping the glass molten.
Well, yeah, because to watch you work with other, I mean, you need a, sort of like a little team of people to do what you do. Like I said, it's a balancing act. It's almost like it part daredevil, part surgeon, part it's amazing.
I love it. It's a little bit like being a magician too, because you start making something and I sort of know what's going to happen, but the audience doesn't always know. And then they're like, wait a minute, how did that just turn into a bowl or a vase or, you know, a sculpture? Like, right. And you watch the whole thing, but you don't know what happened.
Whereas with Nevi, I broke again. Yeah. So how do you even let some of these pieces go? If I made something like, well, like this, or like that, or that. I don't know if I can let go of it. It's just, you know, it's like, aren't they like your little creative children? Oh, I love the flower.
I love making things and then giving them to the world. I love for people to see them and interact with them. So I make these smaller sculptures, but I also make large scale installations. And the more people that can see that work and be affected by it, that's what makes me really happy as an artist. For me, it's the process of creating. It's not so much the product at the end of the process.
God, that's almost zen-like. That was very well said.
Well, after our conversation, April was nice enough to even let me try my hand at it. And with a little, well, a lot of help from Rebecca Silverman, I actually kind of made a flower. A flower you'll never see in nature, of course, but at least I gave it the old UTR try. So if you're looking for a glass master who can make anything from a tiny table topper to a huge, awe-inspiring installation, look up April Wagner at Epiphany Studios in Pontiac. And if you love art in general, just be glad you live in Michigan, because when it comes to creativity, this is one heck of a great place to be. Because remember, you gotta have art.
Let's catch up. Not online or over text. Let's catch up in a place where time isn't measured in minutes, but in moments. Moments made paddling the day away on a crystal blue waterway. Or just sitting around a campfire beneath a canopy of twinkling stars. It's time to make up for lost time. This summer, let's catch up with Pure Michigan.
The Michigan Economic Development Corporation is dedicated to enabling economic prosperity. The MEDC markets Michigan with a focus on growing businesses and building resilient communities in our state.
A visit to the Stahl's Auto Collection will take you back to a time when cars were more than just a way to get around. A fantastic assortment of gas pumps, neon signs, and automated music machines dating back 150 years that must be seen and heard. Info at stahlsauto.com. AnnArbor.org is your gateway to Chelsea, Dexter, Manchester, Milan, Saline, Ypsilanti, and Ann Arbor. Find out the best spots to eat, festivals to attend, activities to do, and places to discover at AnnArbor.org.